Hi, it's me, the Hidden Object Guru. I hope you're having a great day. I know I am. We're going to start off tonight with more Beyond Blue, a game that... Hey, Wesley, I'm a little too happy with. Does that make sense? I've been open in the past about my love for literally any video game about scuba diving. I'm just like, oh, you put scuba diving in a video game? Yep, I'm there. That's it. That's all I needed to know, is that there's scuba diving in the video game. As long as it's not a multiplayer shooter. I can't stress that part enough. No, I'm waiting for it to respond. I didn't mean to click on the screen. Don't be difficult, game. So, I completed my project in Serious Sam. I mean, I still have to make the video, but I completed the work, which is finding out how big the map in Serious Sam 4's open world levels are. And it's 19,000 square kilometers, which is, fun fact, a lot of square kilometers. Aw, way to go. Songs of the Humpback Whale. You're not that late, we just started. Alright, let's do this. Anytime you want to finish loading. Now there. Hidden Object Guru here with more of... Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to switch to audio. Keep. I thought it was supposed to... Alright. I thought it wasn't going to play licensed music. Or maybe this is the original music. Oh. Okay. Maybe not. Yes, no, it was an unusually loud song. Oh, well, they're all uploaded, Lance, so I'll start putting them up tonight. Hey, Mr. Pug, what's up? Of course I'm ready for October. We're going to be playing nonstop horror games. Well, not nonstop, just one a day. But still, one a day. Sometimes more than one a day. Deep sea mining research, you say? Atoll map. I know they're not atolls, they're atolls, but meh. Where is the rest of Andrea's family? Octopus behavior. Up in the viewer. Propeller looks old. Trace back trash. Sign and send clinical trial authorization. Okay. God, this sub looks amazing. My God, is a whale hanging out? Oh, that's a clinical trials paper. Such a freaky place to sleep. She's got a stuffed bunny! Aww. I'm a big fan of you already, main character, who is named Mirai, after a character from Senran Kagura. That part isn't true, but I wish it were, because Mirai is very entertaining. It was whale-tacular. Aww. Nice. Gonna quickly check something that I really should have done earlier. Hold on, everybody. Okay, deeply, profoundly sorry about that, everybody. I recorded two VR videos last night, and the audio was still on my Vive. So you were hearing me through the terrible built-in microphone on a VR headset 9 feet away from me. It was not great. But hey, we're working now. Let me just make sure I can hear me okay. Via the power of science. All right, there we go. Sorry about that in advance. Let's restart the recording, huh? There we go. I played a VR game. That was one of the worst controlling VR games I've ever played. I actually really liked House Flipper, the game. And I played House Flipper VR and... yes, Horror King. I played House Flipper VR and it was an unmitigated disaster. It is impossible to control. And y'all can watch the video later. But I kind of freak out a little, demanding to know how any video game can ask people to get on their hands and knees and scrub virtual floors. That's insane. It is insane that you would ask someone to do that. And you can say, well, you know, it's simulation. Sponge mops exist. No one in real life has to get on their hands and feet and scrub a floor. Very much.
Do you remember that story?
Which one?
The story I had about the customer that was in my store that was like, I used to work for this company. I was a manager. I used to make my staff go around on their hands and knees with, like, tape wrapped around their hands into all the corners of the floor to get all of the dust and everything that would accumulate in the floor that no mop or broom.
Then you were a god-awful manager.
And I was like, then I would have quit. And it became a joke with that staff that that's what I was going to make them do.
I know.
Because I was like, you're a horrible...
You're a terrible boss. Nice, Lance. Well, then you're going to enjoy the next month. They're kind of my specialty, too. That's one of the reasons I love hidden object games so much. Most of them are horror-themed. All right, here we go. Hidden Object Guru here, back for more Beyond Blue, a game I adore because it's about hanging out with whales underwater. Hanging out with whales outside of water is kind of creepy, and I don't really approve of it. All right, let's do this. Humpback songs in the region share a very closely related phrase structure. Good to know.
Hey, Mirai. How are you?
Do you know that crows from one part of the country can't speak to crows from another part of the country? Because their language is that complicated?
Getting my sea legs.
Next step, diving.
Like there's East Coast crow and West Coast crow.
But I promise you,
and they're different languages.
Is Andre with you?
No, just me.
Crows are a lot like rappers in that way.
Some sound files. In the other lab. I think I may have upset him.
You upset him? Or that noise upset him? Because it certainly upset me.
That's a strong point.
And I pointed it out.
I was not overreacting.
Andre's here!
I didn't realize you were on. What did you find?
This is video and audio from your last dive.
And it was Dagon, right?
This is an analysis of the sound that spooked the family. And this sound is from a Canadian marine acoustic scientist. I think the findings are pretty clear.
Uh-oh.
The signatures sound the same to me.
He gave me the same test.
Andre, who is messing with my whales?
Deep sea miners.
Oh.
Here? In the research zone?
Well, that's
it's
disappointing.
It's off limits to commercial activity.
And when has that ever mattered before?
We don't know that they're in the research zone. They may be just outside it. We knew they were doing an impact study nearby.
Ugh, what miners are the worst. That might give us a you might wake up some sort of Dagon. To make solar panels. Could the sound That's what happened in that underwater movie. Spoiler alert. Pushed them to quieter hunting grounds, but was unlikely
to cause acoustic trauma. So what's the move?
We should use our mapping drone to investigate their activity.
And this is where our debate turns into an argument. We need to map the deep sea
I haven't played the Depth Hunter games.
Is the perfect cocktail for creating new life forms.
If there is illegal activity there, we have to stop it. Otherwise, there will be no life forms.
Oh, please tell me I get to blow up undersea drills.
Policing rather than researching. Let's be scientists.
Mirai, your dive, your call.
I'm sorry, we have to... I know this is going to sound crazy, but if we don't investigate the miners, there aren't going to be any vents to map.
I'll dive in the vents without a map. Nobody messes with my whales.
Damn right.
Hey, Mirai. Sorry I missed you. Misplaced my phone.
Whale-a-palooza? I did not, whore, okay.
Is that a real thing? Tell whomever annoyed you, I'm coming.
I've been swamped with replies today and retweets. Because I told people about my upcoming visual novel.
No word on cool. yet.
I think I played the first Endless Ocean. Was that on PS3? Whichever PS3 ocean diving game, I had to import it from Japan. Or no, I guess from, well, a Japanese company. No, not Hong Kong company. It was in English, though. What's up? Hold on 1 second, everybody. I'll be right back. I'm back. What do I play these games on? This game is great. Beyond Blue, Mr. Pug. As you know, I'm a giant... as I keep talking about, I'll play anything with... diving. But this is an especially good game. What are those? What do I play these on? I normally... yeah, I know Horror King, but I've been swamped with responses to other stuff. I play things mostly on PC, but I will also play on PS4 and Switch when that is what the game is on. And so how do I go into the dive? It's saying dive ready, but we never actually covered how to dive. How did I start a dive? Do I start it from the... Oh, look! There's a catalog of all the fishies I found! Oh, I've only found like half the fish. Oh, check it out. There's all the music. Nice. So do I start the dive from the chair? Is that what I did yesterday? It's bad that I don't remember. But yes, I mostly play on... okay, well, no, that's just messaging. I'm unsurprised. It doesn't seem like the kind of game where you can get killed. Oh, I have to grab my dive suit. Right, there we go.
Day 5. Open ocean, east of the atoll.
Oh, how do I horror livestream games using the Switch? I plug it into my capture card. Same way I broadcast Girls in Panzer. You just plug it right into the capture card. I know what you're thinking. Can't you just stream from PS4? No, you can't stream Girls in Panzer because it's all copyrighted music, so everything is turned off for Girls in Panzer. You can't stream the game. Which is why I'm the only person on the internet who plays Girls in Panzer, because it's a hassle. Not a ton of people, like the Venn diagram of people who have capture cards and people who care about Girls in Panzer is like, only me is where they meet. Hey, buddy.
That's what everyone says.
Aww. Hey, it's the dive cable. I love these. Boing. All right, let's do it. Hey, there's a giant whale over there. All right, what have we got?
Hey, a newcomer.
Aw, adorbs. Well, that's obviously something metallic.
Weird. Now to get there before the noise from Andrea's miner friends scares them all away.
You almost raised my blood pressure.
Aw. Hey, buddy. No, don't run away from me. I want to be friends. Aw, bottlenose dolphin. And he didn't even headbutt me, which is rare for a bottlenose dolphin. They're kind of dicks, famously. Orca! Watch out. Orcas are,
expecting to find orcas here.
Murderous beasts.
Top of the food chain, just like us. Minus the urge to destroy ourselves.
I don't know. I feel like if you gave orcas thumbs, they'd be real jerks. Fun fact, orcas, one of the earliest names for them was whale killers. And then, because that was, there were Germans who found them, the people translated it directly. So they thought they were killer whales. But of course, they're not whales. They're dolphins. Giant, murderous dolphins. Not at all Horror King, because all I ever do is broadcast. He's asking if it's a hassle to use a capture card for live streams, and it's not, because all I ever do is broadcast my screen. And, you know, I just put the capture card on my stream, on my screen. Oh, hey, Orky. No, I missed it.
Hello to you, too.
Aww. Hey, buddy. What's going on there? Oh, it's the pattern on his back. That's pretty cute. Alright, who's this guy? Is that a giant turtle? I think I found a giant turtle, people. No, it's just another ocean sunfish. Which is kind of huge, actually. Nice. Yeah, it was hard when I had a capture device because, you know, there's like a 3-second lag for game playing. But with a capture card instead of a capture device, the lag is at, like, you know, 50 milliseconds. Which is, you know, bad enough to screw up my game of Spelunky, but other than that, no effect at all. Moon jellyfish! Watch out for jellyfish, people. They're nightmarish immortal beasts who want only to murder you. That might be overstating things slightly. Ooh, Sharky Shark? Hey, Sharky Shark.
Andre, are you seeing this? I didn't think there were any left.
Finally! Been looking for turtles this whole time. Aww, poor turtlies. I'm not familiar with this ocean sunfish, but it's very creepy. What is a pilot fish? Now, Crates ductor, you say? So is the pilot right there in the name, and that's why we call them conductors? Because it's a similar root word? I don't know enough about Latin that I'm comfortable saying. All right, let's go check out this mystery signal, shall we? It was electronic. Oh, it's just another back turtle. Aww. Hey, buddy. Come on.
Biosample acquired.
Do you think your turtles are making a comeback?
I wish I could be optimistic. It's just as likely our turtle is taking the long road home to somewhere else.
Aww. Poor buddy. He tries so hard. So that's the one I found earlier. I just forgot to scan him. Meaning there's another turtle around here somewhere.
Okay.
I see.
Group survey. New or a repeat?
That is a lot of humpback whale. Hey, I'm visible on the scan. Nice.
So glad to hear you. Those noisy neighbors silenced enough of your friends.
Aww. What am I doing next? Right, the tail pattern. It's as good as a fingerprint, you know.
New whale!
I don't know if that's true.
Designate this one M4, because why mess with a good thing?
The sounds don't sound like the prior sounds.
These are more social sounds.
I'm uncomfortable being this far away from the atoll. I don't like being out in the open ocean. I like to know that there are rocks I can hide behind if things turn south. Ooh, what's that? Hey, buddy. Another ocean sunfish? No, it's yeah, it's another ocean sunfish. Those things are so weird looking. Creepy. Manta! Hey, buddy! Okay, devil ray, but still. If Tampa wanted you as their mascot, you can't be all bad. I don't know if that's true.
And that buoy is my present. Hope it's better than my last birthday.
Dare I ask?
My sister got me jeans that were.
Oh yeah, we were swimming with whales yesterday.
They wandered off, never to be seen again. A mystery, I tell you.
Yeah.
But here's a tweet about the debate.
Go.
As a candidate, arguing with the moderator.
Did you not charge any of these batteries before you put the sensor in?
Trump's arguing with a Fox moderator?
Yep.
Oh. And I'd be embarrassed for him if he wasn't a monster.
I've seen everybody say Joe Biden said.
Yeah.
Will you shut up, man?
Wow.
Apparently it's horrible and you made the right choice not to watch.
No, I mean, I'll watch the clips later. Like, it's going to be a nightmare to watch live for 2 hours.
So what I'm saying is, thanks for coming by, everyone. Good choice.
Hello. I just met your friends.
Yeah, don't be nice to orcas. They're monsters. Well, kind of they are monsters. I was going to, like, take that back a little, but they're pretty freaky.
Are you sure
they love to kill. They eat baby whales, is my point. And we're pro-whale in this game. What is it now?
Seth Meyers' tweet. Trump is holding his own against Wallace so far.
Okay, that is very funny. Alright, what do we got going on here?
Arena, do you think this one could be sick?
Oh.
Fair enough.
You don't have to be a jerk about it, Arena. Oh, this is so beautiful. But I would like to get back to the atoll ASAP. Atoll SP, if you will. Should not have said that. That was a very dumb thing to say. Hey, Ranger, good to have you back. Hope you're having a great day and you've decided to spend the evening with me instead of the presidential debate. Although you said for you it was the morning, not the evening. See, I pay attention when people talk. Who said I don't? Okay, people who know me. That's true. I'm going to scan all y'all. Mola Mola, you say? Don't know what that refers to, but it's a cute name.
Dolphins. Always showing off. Hey, Andre, can you make your manta drone do synchronized swimming?
Guess we'll see.
Aww. Look at all these jellyfish. What is... Oh, is this more hammerheads? I didn't know hammerheads were such social animals. They're like swimming in a clump. Very weird. Aww, they look so playful. I know I'm supposed to be doing quest missions, but I just love tagging fish. What can I say? This game is, you know, not made specifically for me, but it might as well have been. The only way it could be better is if we also solved a murder mystery while we were down here. Hey, it's sardines! Nice.
You're right. It is definitely not a dead battery. Unless we're using whale sharks as batteries now.
Any more remora kicking around? No? Huh. Well, that's weird.
There's already a tag on it.
Then scan the tag.
Sure. Like, that was obvious.
That actually is pretty obvious.
I'm leaving another tag.
Huh. So who's tagging these fish? I know it's not technically a fish. Fish indeed. Seriously. Oh, there it is.
Much better than a dead battery.
At least that explains why we At least that explains why we're hearing a bunch of beeping. You turned on the air conditioner? Very smart. It's going to get hot in here real soon, lady.
I'm going to try and remake my cup of tea and not fall asleep.
Why do you have to remake your cup of tea?
Because it's ice cold.
Right, you fell asleep instead of drinking it. I totes forgot. For some reason, I thought you had drank it before you fell asleep.
Nope.
Aww. Oh, that's the scanner. Sorry, sardines. You thought you could escape me. But you were wrong, my dear. Hey, bottlenose. Please don't headbutt me. I would appreciate that the most. They're definitely going to go eat those sardines, aren't they? Well, such is nature. Wait, where am I supposed to go? Up or down? Oh, there. It is this guy. Okay.
Let's log you in.
Aww. They're so weird. Love it. Alright, where to... Oh, right. Back to scan again. Fish, Horror King. All you missed was fish.
Fish?
Beautiful, luminous fish. They were, as the kids say, fish-tacular. Alright, I've been accidentally, bumping into my mouse and screwing up the camera. I'll try and get it somewhere stable so I can relax and enjoy this wonderful trip through the ocean. I do not play many games. Just really shooters with mouse and keyboard. That's a lot of shark. Hey, buddy. I'm glad you don't see me as a threat. So the pilot fish hang out with sharks? I'm not familiar with this behavior, but it's kind of creepy.
Didn't you
Are they driving the fish?
The baby's pod out here?
For the shark?
I said they were heading in this direction.
Oh, Lance. I hope you enjoy yourself. Watching the debates without knowing about politics. You're a lot like Trump in that respect.
That's mean.
Isn't it? Trump has no idea about politics.
Andre,
I feel like
the buoy is glitching. I don't know what range you've set, but I think I'm hearing all the animals in the Pacific.
Yeah. Too many sound signals for the
sun. Obviously, I didn't mean that. No one should ever be compared to Donald Trump. Unless they're one of Donald Trump's children.
Pretty sure I'm going to love it.
Or his scumbag family members, obviously.
Humbags?
What the hell is that?
Very unusual, but everyone's got to eat.
I've saved it.
I'll try not to be mistaken for a fish.
That's amazing! A giant cloud of fish and all the various predators are coming to just chompity-chomp them. Oh, that's so cool.
Of course dolphins show up. Never like being left out of the action.
I'm sure this is a real thing.
Good luck to them. They're up against bigger stomachs.
Now, can I scan the cloud of fish? Oh, that looks amazing. E indeed, Ranger. Indeed. Wow. Alright, so who am I supposed to use the A button on? The big guy? Probably the big guy, right? Look at all these fish reacting in real time to me. Now you know you're dealing with the future of video game AI. And if you know what that's a reference to, be the first commenter below the video to mention it, and you'll win a prize. Just drop it in the comment section below the video, along with time code for where in the video I asked the quiz question, and boom! A prize is yours.
I like prizes.
Do you know what that was a reference to?
No. Wait, what was the reference?
I said, look at the fish swimming out of my way. This is the future of video game AI.
Oh.
Okay, you just disconnected my monitor for a second. I don't know how. But you kicked a ottoman and my screen went blank. Very weird. That's not a complaint. I was just surprised.
Here they are. You were right.
You came right back.
I guess I didn't just swim across the Pacific for nothing.
Aw, hey guys. Some sort of a fox? Well, at least it's not underwater. I didn't think that would go very well for foxes. Alright, so where do I tag this guy? Oh, right there. Yes. Now I gotta find the other one, right? I mean, it can't have gotten far. It's a giant humpback whale. A hilarious hurricane. It was a deeply solid pun. Even by pun standards. Thank God I finally figured out how to use this camera.
Are there fewer than before in this pod? Or am I just getting faster at tagging?
Excuse me.
Oh, no, don't leave me. The mother stayed with the baby this time.
Aww.
Okay, ready for playback? I've prepared a coda you can activate from your dive watch.
Tell me more about this coda. Oh, baby whale.
Aww. Okay, first attempt to speak whale.
We're trying to talk whale, speak whale.
Like in that time?
Yeah, you're thinking of Star Trek IV. Yeah.
I was actually going to go to a really roundabout, you know, explanation of Star Trek IV. Like,
clicks.
Almost undecipherable what
body.
I'm talking about.
Gotcha.
Checking me out. And
eventually, you'd be, I'm like, you know, the guy with the headband, the sweatband around his face.
You have no idea what
you know,
felt like.
He was white, and then he jumped the tank.
Right at me.
And then...
Yeah, I get it.
You have no idea.
It's hilarious.
Take me to your weapons.
Nuclear vessels,
that's what it is.
Sadly, no, Horror King. It's a much more obscure reference.
What did you think it was?
It's certainly not a reference to something I said. But I'm not going to give it away. Cool, Lance. You have a great meal, I hope. Along came a butterfly. Book of poems. Aww. Everybody, be sure to like the stream. Apparently, that is the entirety of how YouTube decides what to show to people. So be sure to hit the like button, or we will not get more people being sent to the stream. YouTube is not in the business of figuring out what's quality. It's only in the business of... That was a very arrogant thing for me to believe. It's only in the business of figuring out what people are watching. All right, Andre, what's up?
The drone we had tracking that intrusive noise?
Oh, no.
Lost contact hours ago.
The miners destroyed our drone.
That noise, but as of now, unless the drone resurfaces, that's all we've got.
See, they told me I was going to go check out a vent, and then I just hung out with whales. And I like hanging out with whales, okay? But, you know.
I assume you've heard that Andre lost the drone.
Did anyone figure out the response to my quiz about, hey, buddy, put her there? No, it's way too obscure. Like I told you, it's basically ungoogleable. I literally know the specific thing it's from, and I was almost unable to Google it.
If this were a space mission, we would probably have 100. You sound a little frustrated. Is that with Andre or the drone situation?
Like, I literally typed into Google the name of the character... that said it, and the thing it was set in, and there were no results. So it's apparently something only I am obsessed with. Or at least, no one else is obsessed with it has put it on the internet.
Not every
like me trying to find Debbie Allen's speech from Fame?
Exactly like that.
Being like, I don't understand!
Give him time. He'll lighten up. I know he thinks your current research is important. And impressive.
It is. Actually, nice.
Put her there, pal! And then, you know, immediately eat somebody. That's right.
Sleep?
Not just kill, but eat somebody.
And the drone,
hey, buddy, put her there! So was that a tornado of fish?
It was magical. It's like the whole ocean glows.
I had a James Bond quiz? What was my James Bond quiz?
Is.
Sounds like fun.
She's alive, but...
Oh no.
Nana moved in with us after our mom died.
Oof! And that's when you learn to skin dive.
Definitely. Yeah, most of the time. It's complex right now. Where is your daughter?
It's bad that I don't know what the James Bond quiz is. That's right, can't remember my own quizzes.
She also has a passion for music. She's been playing in the same indie band for years.
Aww.
What's her music like?
Hard to describe. I'm sure so.
Nice work, Mike.
I'll send you her latest single.
Ugh.
Isn't it?
It's true. Doom Eternal is the worst game.
My sister took a break for a few years, but she's back now.
There's a story there.
Rawr.
I've warned you.
She's had to deal with tough stuff. We both have. I just seem to have an easier time adjusting.
You're so understanding, Mirai. We're right after this, Ranger.
I don't think
what's right after this?
The game we're playing next.
Yay! What game?
Why don't you just find out right after this?
But I want to know now.
Yeah, I'm not telling you.
Yeah. Complex.
Did you tweet it?
Well, Horror King, the quiz was who said the line, so if I told you the name of the character, that kind of gives away the whole quiz, doesn't it? You see my logic there, right? Let's see what Ren's up to.
Hi, Mirai. Must be
probably warehouse gymnastics.
I'm on dive time.
No? Okay.
Yeah? Did she like the whales?
It's hard to know. She did huff at the dolphins, though.
She used to redo that story every night.
Yeah, you
that's
told
sweet.
Me, I don't really remember.
Oh.
Are you doing okay with that? Kind of. You do this better.
And I have a bandit. Oh, look at those hammerhead sharks dropping by for a visit. They're curious about the station.
I can look at coming back earlier. That's crazy talk. Go speak to your whales.
Aww.
Gonna try. Catch you later.
All right. Explore the seamount area where the sperm whale family has been diving and hopefully figure out what's going, okay. And hopefully figure out what's going on with that underwater drill. You know, stop them before they wake up Dagon. What? It's danger. You don't want to wake up Dagon.
No.
Let the dude sleep.
Yeah.
Day 7.
Well, he'll wake up Cthulhu if you wake him up.
That's valid.
I'm following Andrea's family down to the sea.
Oh, that was loud.
Observed them hunting. Arena has been testing our samples and is worried about a harmful algal bloom being somewhere nearby.
Uh-oh. Algae blooms are the worst.
Check.
They're poison.
I'm also keeping an eye out for more turtles. I know they're out there, ready to die.
I'm gonna find another turtle?
I'm in and okay.
Oh, right, the James Bond movie and the
Welcome.
Dive
Welcome
in
back.
The driving game. Yeah,
I'm
of course.
Diving near a sea mountain.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, no one solved that quiz.
Twilight Zone.
Well,
because
it's of course. Yeah, there's a Facebook page for the Hidden Object Guru. Just click on all of my video descriptions. There's a list for it.
Did you fix the broken link on it?
It worked fine when I clicked on it, so I don't know what happened there. We were told last night there was a... Whoa, who's that flashlight? Oh, no, it's just one of the drones. Okay, I was worried.
But you don't, like, update...
Exactly, one answer for per person. People are only allowed to make one guess. Spider crab! God, those things are so creepy. People are only allowed to make one... What is a silver chimera? Ooh. Scandalous. Aww. Such a cute little fishy. With monster alien eyes. Seriously, though, what the hell? We just found a storage container at the bottom of the ocean? Oh, this ain't good. Well, at least it's empty. Not full of toxic waste that's turning sharks into... Super Sharks. That is a reference to Maneater, the video game I just played. Seriously great game, Maneater. Like, just an amazing, one of the best open world games in recent memory. Just fantastic.
Yes, but your James Bond quiz...
That's a very difficult quiz.
And admittedly, you said my first answer was also, like, could have been...
It could have been valid, but there's a very specific scene I was talking about.
It was my second guess.
Exactly.
I'm hoping that buoy can send a little message to our
humpbacks. The hell is that thing?
That's right. Andre is going to serenade some humpbacks.
Aww. Oh, not me, but using a song I generated from other... That is one hell of a manta. What kind of manta was that? It's going to leave before I get a chance to see it, sadly. Well, yeah, because if I let people do more than one answer per person in the quiz, you can just name all the James Bond movies. That wouldn't exactly be fair. What the hell is that sound? Definitely mechanical. Is it the drill again? Alright, can I catch that manta? Yep, there it is. Well, it's not a manta. Or maybe this one is. Oh, an octopus squid. I really thought that was another kind of ray. But yeah, that's visibly a squid. It's got a glowing leg section. That's so creepy. Way to go, Squiddy. Squiddy, Squiddy, Squiddy. Love my little Squiddy. Squiddy, 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 rock and roll.
What the hell are you singing about?
What's that?
I said, what the hell are you singing about?
Well, if people know, they'll win the quiz that I was about to announce. What was that Squiddy song I was singing just then? Do you know what that is a reference to, or what that's from?
And feasting on some moon jellies.
That is odd. Is that the same one we saw before?
It looks bigger, but let me zoom scan it to be sure.
Drop in the... If you know what that was a reference to, drop in the Squiddy song. Drop it in the comments section below the video, along with the time code for where in the video I asked the quiz question, and boom! A prize is yours! Don't know what that is, Rangers. The Beatles don't do songs about mollusks.
We can run the sample in the lab, but I am sure this is a different one.
Oh, he's so cute!
Would it be surprising to find two this far off course?
It would. God, look at him chomping at that.
Enjoy your beautiful moon jellies.
Oh. I mean, jellyfish are really more things than they are animals. They don't have... They barely have nervous systems. They're very strange creatures.
Were you stung by one once?
It turned out it was dead, so it didn't actually sting me. Huh. It just, like, the body of a dead jellyfish brushed against me. I freaked out and ran out of the ocean, as you can imagine, but then people saw it floating and it's like, oh, it's dead and you don't have any welts, so you're probably fine. Apparently welts turn up almost immediately. But yeah, I immediately freaked out. Jellyfish touching me? Yeah. But yeah, I guess it's not just a chemical thing. They actually have to mean to sting you. Or at least, they have to be alive enough to react that way. Obviously, they do have some nervous system. I'm just saying they're not intelligent in a way we would recognize or understand. Would I rather go underwater or to Mars? Underwater. Obviously. There's stuff to see underwater. Mars? Just a lot of rocks. You know what? I can see rocks on Earth. The only reason to go to Mars is to do the research for... one day terraforming it, which is cool and everything, but that's not my jam. My jam is hanging out with living creatures. Especially ones that like to be cuddled, like manta rays. Seriously, I say like manta rays. Everything likes to be cuddled. Spoiler alert. There's no such thing as a living thing that doesn't like scritches and cuddles. They all do. And yet humans and some monkeys...
Okay. Time to see if any humpbacks
are the only things that can
Jordan wants to know.
Scritch animals. Animals can't scritch each other.
We have raccoons. Recorded him before.
What's that?
We'll raccoons. See if the
raccoons can scritch. Well, and of course, red panda. Which are just Japanese raccoons. The rocks aren't actually red. That's the color of the atmosphere on Mars. The rocks are normal rock color.
Red rocks, you have to go to PEI.
Or, you know, certain deserts in America and China.
Before, right?
And, of course, Australia.
You compare his two songs?
It's hilarious. Of course, everyone's followed a Rickroll link.
Wow.
At one time
or
another.
Slow ballad.
We got Rickrolled at a wedding.
Yep.
It was fabulous.
Fantabulous, even. I want to get back to the A-12.
The last wedding we went to.
Yeah.
For probably a while.
Yeah, this plague has really cut our desire to go to weddings, even if we were invited.
The majority of people we know do not want to, like...
endanger people's lives. Yeah. For their own... Oh, the John Dory fish! That really does look like a dude's face. Check it, yo.
Yep.
I see why you would name that after a dude. I have not read The Borrowers. You, lady?
Which one's The Borrowers?
It's about miniature creatures that live behind the wall and steal stuff.
Oh, yeah, totally. Yeah.
Okay. Did you enjoy it?
Yeah.
There you go.
Immensely. I mean, I remember very little of it because it was a long time ago. But
nice. Yeah. Squiddy, squiddy, squiddy. A little squiddy. That might be impossible to Google.
The movie was very disappointing.
Gotcha.
Despite, I want to say John Goodman.
I love John Goodman.
But, you know, it was not.
Careful. Squid. It looks like they're hunting. I watched that movie Flight, and he had a hair in a ponytail, and I'm like, did he film this while he was growing out his hair for Llewellyn
Let's
Davis?
To pick up their hunting behavior.
That's really awesome. See you soon, Ranger. I hope you have a great time.
God, that's a good movie.
Yeah, it is. Careful.
I mean, maybe not a 2020 watch?
No.
Like, maybe.
Kind of a downer.
I think this one was upset.
Not the happiest movie of the bunch.
Still a really good movie.
Not at the bottom, though, either.
Yeah. Am I not close enough to scan this dude? There we go. Got most of the octopus squids. Cool. Is it a very long book, or is it something you can zip through in a day or two, this The Borrowers?
Not even.
Oh, really?
Not even a day.
Okay. Is that comb jelly?
Huh. I'm pretty sure it's a kid's book, isn't
it?
It
is a kid's book, yeah. They're a long kid's book. Secret of Nim's a long book. Well, not super long, but long-ish.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Evergreen Forest, or whatever that was called.
No, it's called the Evergreen Forest. The cartoon was called the Green Forest.
That's where I get confused.
Yeah. And every book kids read today are like 400, 500 pages.
That's valid.
Boom. Of course I'm streaming again. I'm here every day, Godwin. That sounds like the, that sounds like the miner in question.
Nope.
I'm gonna get these guys. They're gonna learn a valuable lesson about messing with my oceans.
Great.
And that is, no one can own these oceans.
First of all, don't mess with my suit when I'm diving. Secondly, you spoiled my surprise.
All right, what am I supposed to zoom scan?
Yeah, it's published in 1952. I'm surprised you haven't read it.
Huh. Watch the show.
Oh,
I'm thinking about Evergreen.
Yeah.
Forest. No, I just had never got around to reading The Borrowers. Read plenty of books. Indian in the Cupboard, you know. Plenty of fun books, but lots of kids.
It's 159 pages or 100.
Oh, okay, yeah, that's like an hour of reading. An hour or two of reading.
I know it's a really fast read, because as a kid I read it super fast.
Yeah, reading 3-4 pages a minute, you'd be done that in an hour and a bit.
Yeah, it was one of my favorites. Close.
There you go, Semper. I think I was in fourth grade when they assigned Indian in the Cupboard as well. What the hell is that thing? Is that one of ours or is that one of theirs? Anyway, let's go focus on the job. Sensor alarm.
What am I looking for here?
Oh, one of our spermo tags must have fallen off.
Andre, you really need better glue for these.
I don't use glue.
I've tracked down the tag. It's in a cave. I wonder how it got in here.
Carried there by one of those super octopuses? Yep. What the? That's what happened.
Are you okay?
Other than getting inked in front of a live global audience?
You know, you might want to get that off you. It will probably attract predators.
Oh, wonderful.
That was creepy. Change light to UV and zoom scan patterns. Okay, but how do I do that? Have we talked about a way to change zoom scan patterns? Controls. Open scanner, yep. Swamp scan. Change light color. Okay, it's Y, everybody. Huh.
Just found out there's one of the books in the series I haven't read because it came out in 82.
Oh. Fascinating and logical,
too. I have not read the last book in that series.
I have not heard Sasha and the Wolf, or heard of Sasha and the Wolf Club, no.
Sasha and...
The Wolf Cub.
I think I have.
No, not me. Oh yeah, look at that. So I go do white light, then I switch to a different color of light. Cool. Human perspective. Okay. Oh, wow.
Small sharks have developed biofluorescence.
Oh, that's so cute.
Their eyes have special adaptations for the UV light. Now you can see what a small shark sees.
That's what I'm talking about.
All right, so... Where's the other fish I need to scan? Comb jelly, spider crab. There he is. Oh. So pretty. So that's infrared there? Since everything's red now, or am I being silly? So this whole time I've had a light I haven't been using. That's a little embarrassing.
Did you try the black light I installed in your stop?
You did not. You did install it in your dorm room back in the day. Your wife.
Pedro says Trump is humiliating himself in the debate.
Nice.
Not really a surprise. He's terrible at everything.
The reason you haven't read it is because I think it was originally published in 96.
Oh, okay. That would be why.
I think for some reason we sold it...
at the comic book store.
Yeah. Or I just read it. I don't know.
I love the very strange tactic that Trump's people put out before the debate to try and say that, what's his name? Joe Biden is senile and incompetent and on drugs and can't string two words together. Don't you know that if you spend 2 months saying that and then he defeats Trump in a debate, Trump looks even worse? How are you so bad at this?
Chances of
although it is interesting to me that that is good. Like that is
if our humpback song
the quintessential
back,
well. Like Trumpian lie.
Yeah, it's true.
It's not magic. True it about patience. Him.
Yeah, it's all projection. I still
this
have
is
a
fascinating. Is there like a technical term for that kind of?
No, it's just projection.
Strange. What like narcissistic lying?
Yeah, no, that is projection. That's what it is. It's one of the things narcissists do.
Yes, it's hunting.
They can't stop it. They can't stop.
With Andre's technology.
Oh, this is awesome. What's this balloon about? Is this one of ours? No, of course it is. Yeah, it's fascinating. Okay. Because people like him can't help but confess all the time. They just do it by accusing other people of the stuff they're doing.
Buzz. I got it.
Like, when you're that, you know, mentally unstable, your subconscious just constantly demands that you confess all the bad stuff you do. You just do it in a weird way.
How is it used?
We're not entirely sure, but...
It's like, what do you call it? It's like the people who get crippled, right? And then they can't admit that they're crippled. So they're like, okay, get out of the bed. And you're like, I don't want to. Why would I get out of the bed? I'm perfectly comfortable here. Okay, well, pick up the water and give yourself a drink. I'm not thirsty. You know? Who will do anything to not have to admit to a thing. It's fascinating.
Andre. Aww. Andre.
Do we found the turtles?
Rah, rah, rah.
They're baby turtles. That's why the two turtle parents were in the area. They were checking on their turtles.
Miles off course. Right, Andre?
Give him a minute.
Right. Let's scan a few of these to get their gender. There's a tiny tag here.
Turtles are a creature that I don't understand how they still exist.
Yeah?
Merely because, like, have you watched anything about their, like, reproduction?
It's so convoluted that you can't imagine that they're surviving?
Yeah.
Yeah, I get it.
So, they're gonna crawl up on a shore.
Lay an egg. Hope, and just leave it alone for months. Yeah. And hope nobody comes along and eats the egg.
And then that turtle is born.
And has to crawl all the way to the ocean and figure out stuff to eat before it gets eaten by something bigger than it. Spoiler alert, everything's bigger than it.
Fascinatingly weird.
Warming beaches wiped out the turtles in this region.
Believe in a little magic now, Andre?
They just start, but let me check on my tag first.
Aww. We gotta find 5 more turtles.
Rah, rah, rah.
Hey, Ranger. Glad to see you. We're just awesome. We're just really enjoying these turtles in the game. It's the clicking of a whale!
Oh, wow. Glad we didn't miss
this. They love to click. Oh, damn, that's a lot of whales.
Yeah, they must have been hunting down past the rift.
You ever seen a whale?
I think we found our spot
in real life?
For our first deep dive.
I know. Check
out no. All of the aquariums I went to didn't have any big whales.
I'm
not sure I can catch
them.
They're heading to the surface.
Nice.
Might just be a scrape from a ship strike.
I've never even seen a... Nope, it's the day gone.
Let's end it here.
Aw, they're so beautiful. Sad I didn't get to scan, though. What you gonna do? No, they're just coming back from a hunt.
I know. It seems like Andre worries about everything.
Aww.
Understand where that comes from.
This is so sweet! Turtle!
I can tell you, it was really tough to be doing hands-on work when we were losing entire species. For me, it was the whales. But for Andre, it was the turtles. I stayed to help him. Several of the other scientists did as well. By then, only Andre's protected nests were the ones producing turtles.
You gotta watch out for Dagon, Mike. Famously.
We all figured that
he's not screwing around.
Was going to collapse and
aww, poor turtle is trying to get to the ocean. I haven't checked the news, Pedro.
Large man spend day after day carrying tiny turtles from the nest to the water. It inspired us to stay.
Well, yes, Dagon is spelled Dagon. Ranger. It's named after it's a thing from H.P. Lovecraft.
Andre is not.
And it's also the name of an actual god that I believe
it's too hard.
Philistines worshipped? No, it might not be Philistines. No, it's older than that.
Yeah, Sumerian?
It's probably Sumerian. Yeah. Oh, we did it! You rescued us some turtles!
Hi, Mariah. Sorry to miss the post-dive brief. I've been listening to our humpback recordings for hours and got myself in a kind of funk.
Oh, no.
Actually, I started listening to the humpbacks and then switched to Miles Davis. Anyway, I don't see any clear sign that our playback...
Wait a minute, you're in a funk and you decided to listen to Miles Davis?
Sorry to be in
some... Music to do heroin to?
Make of those turtles.
I'm so sorry.
Like, that is not
I've been there. Right.
Catch you
that is not a good move, dude.
I actually have an amazing collection over yonder that I should.
Oh, no, he's great. Don't get me wrong. Yeah. Nobody's complaining about Miles Davis. But come on. Not music to listen to when you're depressed. You get caught in a loop. Look at all these fishies! Oh my god, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We've only got 10 fishies left to find! What? It's going great. I have seen the movie Dagon. It's, of course, not an adaptation of anything about Dagon. It's just Shadow over Innsmouth. But it's a fun movie. Yet another adaptation of Shadow over Innsmouth. So yeah, we're halfway through the game-ish, because as you can see, we've seen 9 things and there's 7 more to see, so halfway through the game-ish. Which means we're going to take a break. I've been the Hidden Object Guru. Thanks for coming on this journey with me. If you had a good time and you'd like to see more, there's buttons for that coming up. Questions, suggestions, related to whatnots, go in the comment section below the video. I'll see you back here for more Beyond Blue, a delightful game about all of the best parts of the ocean. The animals! But until then, I'm going to say that's right. Au revoir. All right, what's next? Oh, it does. Of course it does, Mike, but I'm just saying, there's also stories more directly about Dagon that, are not Shadow over Innsmouth. Content creator settings. I would love to exit game. I mean, I would love to, but, you know. I just saved. Don't do that to me. Also, why don't you autosave? Come on, game. Help me out a little.
Why don't all games autosave?
It's insane. I mean, it makes no sense. Boom. Oh, it's true, Mike. But I'm just saying, there's other H.P. Lovecraft things to do than just Shadow over Innsmouth over and over again. Yeah, that's what I'm getting at. Oh, nice. Wait, I thought it was about a space station. Now you're saying it's a water station on an alien planet? Okay. It might just be future horror, not space horror, Rangers. Hidden Object Guru here with hot new game Pamela, which is future horror. One of my favorite kinds of horror. Permadeath off, yep. Melee only off. Wounded effect off. Always wanted off. Jesus. I don't even know what this game is, so no, I'm not playing it on hard. Thanks. Ina's power system is completely renewable, but not fully self-sustaining. Huh? Ina units dock together to share power and resources in order to make up for any deficits. And I didn't finish reading that again. Come on, guys! Help me out here. So yeah, I saw this game. Looked to be creepy, horror, maybe a little action. Thought it was set in outer space. I was obviously wrong about that. Although that says Origin Station, so I don't know what I'm talking about, I guess. And they were nice enough to send me a copy. Thank you very much. There is nothing but hard settings of Doom Eternal, Mike. As long as the Marauder exists, there's no such thing as easy. The end. Literally, the worst thing to have ever been in a video game. I'm going to pause for the rest of this loading, because why do people want to watch loading screens? Squiddy, 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 rock and roll. Oh, weird. Power tools, eh? They're going to be a bunch of Dead Space type jive in this, because I'd be down for that. Okay, almost there. Hey, Cameron, what's up? All right.
A flash of light.
There are no subtitles.
To the countless firing circuits in my mind.
Oh, hey.
My creators, Jacob and Emma, looking
down. Oh, I'm playing as a robot? Nice.
Eden, they told me, would be my home. Aww. A marvel of technical and social engineering.
Yeah, I was promised robots.
As time went on, my creators taught me to watch over and protect the citizens.
Then the robots killed everybody?
The creation of the arm connected me with each and every one of them, allowing me to feel their emotion and see through their eyes.
That's creepy.
With each passing day, they made me feel more and more human. Medical breakthroughs all but eliminated disease as we delivered vaccinations through each citizen's arm.
Oh, weird. And then we turned them all into murderous zombies. Somebody hacked into the arm units and turned everyone into murderous zombies.
On each other, blind with madness.
So it's BioShock by way of the Surge. Okay, I'm down for that.
I tried to react, to slow the madness. But with each passing day, my hope began to fade.
So I'm controlling the AI.
Creators tear each other apart.
The AI in charge of the station?
Alone in the darkness, I cut myself off from Eden and waited for it to end.
Damn, girl.
Until I realized I had one final hope.
Oh.
Frozen in stasis, untouched by the virus, you could help me save my people.
I think they're all zombies, though.
I don't wish this nightmare upon anyone.
Comedy gold.
I still hear their screams of desperation in the
Horror
dark.
King.
But I need you to wake up.
I'm kidding. I just didn't see your comments. I've been looking away. I don't know what's gonna stack up to Soma, Mike. The fact that there's enemy health and ranged weapons suggests that it's going to be a little more action-y than Soma. Obviously, I can't say for sure. Oh, no. Alright, let's do this.
Are you alright? You're one of the only viable sleepers left in the system. And I was worried that... Well, that doesn't matter.
Is this a roguelite?
I don't have much time to explain.
Yeah.
My name is Pamela, and I've woken you up in my city, Eden.
Hey, Pamela, what's up?
I need your help. But first, I need you to help yourself.
I would love to do that.
Search this clinic to find some food and supplies. You're going to need them.
How do I search? Hey, I got a body.
I'll contact you again soon.
Nice.
Be careful. The citizens of Eden have been...
Low-budget video games tend to look a lot better than low-budget movies. Because low-budget video games can, you know, use assets that already exist and can use a framework to build new assets. Not easily, but much more inexpensively than you can do anything in movies. Yeah, I never played the Persistence. Mike, they did not send me a copy, so I never got a chance to play it. Not only that, they didn't just ignore me. They full-on rejected the idea that I deserved a copy.
What?
Oh, yeah, it was weird. I'm like, I don't get rejected from any games. But yeah, they were like, nope, this guy doesn't get a copy of The Persistence. I'm like, is it because I went on Twitter and said, oh, is this yet another System Shock 2? Probably not. They probably didn't see my Twitter, but you know.
Admittedly,
I did do
you
that.
Have lost a job or two by doing that.
That is true.
Remember the writing job you met with the show creators for? Where you were like, oh, so it's just like, what was it, The Wire? Or
oh, so it's
like
just
that?
The Wire.
Yeah. And they were not okay with you recognizing what they were ripping off, so you did not get that job.
That was pretty funny, actually. Okay, IVG, scan nearby. Oh, okay. That's
like
cool.
Is locked. You need to bypass its security coroutines to open it. Locked containers are usually protected for a reason, and often hide valuable equipment.
Alright, so where's this locked container you're telling me about? Oh, that one. Okay. How do I unlock it? She's busy playing Sudoku, so she can't jump in. Oh, hacking! Nice! So yeah, getting real System Shock vibes here. Lock containers and doors that are not locked by key codes can be hacked to gain access. In the logic hacking minigame, use directional pad to choose ciphers matching the glyph below. Then press A to decryption. Do you mean to decrypt? Oh, damn. Okay. I can do that. I hope. Alright, so. Okay. Alright, so let's look at this thing. Alright, so available security bypasses, I don't have any.
Oh, so I have to make that symbol. I see. Is that it? That is it. Yay! We got trophies! You have a great night, Cameron. I found a circuit, I found adhesive, and I found a security bypass. Tell me more. How do I look at my inventory? Have they told me that yet? God, I love games that let you ping for items. I'm not saying I will never play a game that doesn't let me ping for items, but it is important to me. Oh, nice! I can use a cryo bay to get awesome new abilities. Cool. Vendor discounts. Hey, Matt. Was ist los? That means what's loose. It's a colloquial German for what's happening. Oh, there's my inventory. I seem to have nothing in it, which is a little weird because I've been picking up items left, right, and center. It feels like a VR interface. Okay. So what has been happening to all these items I've been picking up? Oh, there. No, that's not them. Maybe they're all, like, usable items, you know, so they're not just sitting in my inventory. Maybe they're all bypasses and food and whatnot. Would I rather communism or democracy? Good question.
Democracy.
Ranger. I'm guessing democracy, but see, the problem is communism and democracy aren't really mutually exclusive. Communism and capitalism are mutually exclusive. But you can still have democratic communism where you vote for the people in charge to set priorities and we all vote together. So communism and democracy are not actually mutually exclusive. They tend to be in the way people live right now, but that's not necessarily the case. So really, you'd have to say which you prefer, communism or capitalism. And of course, obviously, communism. Capitalism's a terrible system, everybody. Boom. An adrenaline hypo. Okay. So I've just picked that up. You all saw me pick it up. Yeah, see, now I have it in my inventory. What was going on earlier? Oh, whatever. Not going to worry about it. That is a handy thing about the map. Mike. That is a good feature, but you got to remember, any game that features the Marauder is worse than any game that doesn't feature the Marauder, so...
Seriously, don't get him going on this.
Obviously, Doom is still the worst video game ever made, even if it has good features, which it does. So, wait, when I was picking up all items... Was that like breaking it and I wasn't actually getting the items? Because when I manually picked up that item, I did get it. Huh. Yeah, there it is. Guess I gotta find another item to figure out for sure. Alright. So I haven't found any food. This game is gonna be like, you have to eat and drink all of the time to keep from fainting. Because it doesn't understand how biology works. That is weird, Mike. Very weird.
What's weird?
Using my full name. Hey, buddy. What's your deal? Hey, I can punch. First person punching, everybody. It almost never works in video games, but fingers crossed it works here. And I can sprint. All right, let's read. Hey, Street. What's up? Can't read that at all. Not a great angle, not a great font. Okay. Hopefully there wasn't like a passcode. Doing okay?
No, I just figured out why I have a headache. You know how they're working on the other row of balconies over there?
Obviously.
I can smell the fumes in the air. Because that window's open.
Alright, so I'm going to say pick up. That's an energy cell. So I picked it up. And now it's in my inventory. There you go, Mike. Well, it's not like my full name is a secret. If you click on my Twitter account, it's right there, because I tell you about all of the movies I've written.
What is using your phone?
Micus.
Oh.
Alright. Besides which, I don't really have a last name I go by. Feel no particularly association with my family name. Okay, no. Lots of searchable items. Very few items to pick up.
Long and hard to spell.
Except that's why I don't feel any particular
in
connection
country,
to it.
Your country, slightly unique.
Not completely, but slightly.
Well, more unique than mine.
Absolutely. There's hundreds of you guys.
Which has led to the joke, why do we always book stuff in my name?
It's comedy gold is what it
time
is.
We got the wrong floor?
Oh, no, it does. I'm just saying there are games where punching works okay. But as a general rule, first-person punching is difficult because in anything but VR games, it's really hard to get the depth perception of how far away enemies are, right? All right. And that's an issue. I'm hearing some kind of a squeaking sound, and I don't like it. No, that squeaking sound was fine. Right, so that's glass, so I pick that up. Is it in my inventory? It is. Okay, we're going to try the auto pick up all items again, because the three times I've picked up something manually, it's wound up in my inventory. But when I clicked on the button, pick up all items, it didn't. So I think this game might have a glitch vis-a-vis that. Ergo, concordantly. That's right. It's literally almost 20 years later, and I'm still making that joke. Well, not making a joke, referencing a joke. Okay, so there's the item glass. I'm going to say pick up all items. All right. And in my inventory, it's not there. Okay, so the game has a glitch. The game has a glitch where if you say pick up all items, the items disappear into the aether. That seems like a problem that is going to make this game hard to play. I guess the answer is never use the pick up all items button, but I feel like items disappearing if you say pick up the item is a glitch they probably should have caught while they were testing it. Oh, Benedict Cumberbatch is reading Sherlock Holmes audiobooks. Good for him. Oh, Cumberbatch, you're so entertaining.
I feel like he'd be good for that.
No, you were supposed to say, who? Or is that too obscure a reference?
It might be too obscure a reference.
Nobody watches Toast of London?
Oh, right.
How every time any actor is mentioned, he says, who? And Benedict Cumberbatch gets talked about all the time on that show because the show is written by a guy who well co-created with Matt Berry. By oh, well, let's watch this first.
If I could be born as a human, would I want to? I never answered at the time. There were many more important things that required my attention. Now, having seen what being human brings, I wonder if it should have been the other way around.
What do you mean? Would humans like to be born as you? Oh, I get it. Very funny, Mike. But yes, so the co-creator is the other guy from Father Ted. There's the one guy from Father Ted who went on to Arthur Matthews, I think?
Be a jackass?
Went on to be a scumbag who did create the ID Crowd, which is a brilliant show. But he's a real scumbag beyond that. And the Arthur Matthews, not so much. Kind of an okay dude, it seems. And so his thing he's famous for is coming up with all of the best names ever. Like, he always has the best character names. And that's why the main character is named Stephen Toast, which is a fantastic name. So when a guy is already, like, the best at making names, obviously it's going to be Carrot Seed Packet. That's weird. Am I going to be planting carrots? It could still happen, Horking. Sorry.
Best at making names.
Yeah, he's the best at making names. So, obviously, Benedict Cumberbatch is such a ridiculously cartoon name. It's one he would go for a lot. Like Michael Fassbender, who also gets talked about a lot.
Yeah, he does.
And Rafe Fiennes.
And then John Hamm was on the show.
Yeah, because John Hamm sounds like a name they would have made up. Other names they've made up include Beezus Fafoon and Pookie Nook.
Oh, what's his name?
Who?
From Star Trek.
Which one?
Discovery, the new one.
Oh, yes, Clem Fandango.
Clem Fandango. I don't actually know the actor's name. I only ever call him
Clem Fandango. Literally the best name any character has ever had. Yeah. Clem Fandango.
And he only ever refers to him by his full name.
Yeah, he only ever says the full name, Clem Fandango. All right, so reflex-based hacking. I have to press a button to make the circle stop into place. Okay. Let's do it. And spinners on the top of the indicated segments. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, yeah, alarm. That didn't go so bad.
You can expand your IVG storage capacity by using expansion modules like the one you just found.
Nice. So, don't destroy that item. All right. Exactly, Mike. That's the kind of name you'd think he would have come up with. But in fact, that is a real person's name. I love those. Imogen Poots. Sadly, she was never mentioned on the show. So you're saying I could get rid of some of these items. Like this energy. Oh, ammo. I want a gun. A water cup. Okay, let's. Well, no, I need to drink that carrot seed packet. All right. Excuse me. So, recycle that. Oh. Did it work? No, it didn't. See, that's recycle all. You don't want to do that. I just want to recycle this. That's very weird, right? Huh. So, the controls in this game have some issues in that it's not always clear how you're supposed to use items, like, at all. Also, I've got ammo. When do I get a gun? I say, I give a first-person melee combat a lot of crap, but I did enjoy Breakdown. I beat it twice. You had to beat that game twice to get to the ending, because it does that crappy thing where you get to the end of the game and it's like, oh, that was a simulation. Single respawn. Nice. Oh, cool. Hey, buddy, what's your deal? Oh. What the hell was that? I stuck out my one arm. Oh no, I'm out of stamina! Must back away. I can block, nice. She just did a kick? Alright, well she's down. Hopefully she learned a valuable lesson about screwing with me, a guy who can punch with metal hands. Alright, let's do this. Oh, is that who that's a picture of in your image? It's Rainbow Dash, who is famously a horse. Morphine, nice. I would like some morphine. Thank you for asking. And then this is my gun? No, it's empty. And then this is my gun? No, it's empty. This game has a weirdly large number of empty containers. I would say 60-70% of the containers I've found in this game have all been empty, to the point of me asking, well, why are they in the game then? Yeah, it might be closer to 90%. Oh, the game is messing up the stream, everybody? Sorry. We're not going to be going too much longer. I want to get a couple of fights going, but I'm very dissatisfied with the level of bugs in this.
How is it messing up the stream?
Some games use too many video game. No, sorry. Some video games use too many resources from the computer, and they end up causing it to judder, which is one of the reasons we're looking at a new video card.
Graphics card.
Yeah, that's the same thing. It's technically a GPU or graphical processing unit.
Subtle reference to that time you sent me to the store next one of the, you know,
one of the what?
Radio Shack, whatever.
Oh.
Next to my store to buy a new Ethernet cable.
Yeah.
And I referred to it as LAN cable and got, you know, crazy corrected by the guy in the store because he didn't know what that was.
It's a very dumb man.
And I was like, it says it on the package.
All right, I can't punch that corpse, which is weird.
So I was trying to make a...
That was a perfect reference. Brilliant, even. I would like a map, please. So I'm currently here. Oh, I can't look at the map while running, huh? Okay. Really love the HUD elements here. They're very friendly. Okay, kiosk, cryotubes. So that's a door I don't know how to open. But there's the... Oh, here's the panel. I feel like the panel should glow. Maybe I need things to be too easy. Hey, Pamela, what's up? Nice. I don't know. Can Sonic spin faster than the speed of light? I've played every Sonic game. I'm kidding. I've only played all of the non-3D Sonic games. But a couple of those, too. And generally, he moves at about 30-40 miles an hour. Not particularly fast. Like, I remember that one time he was running away from an orca. And he was having real trouble staying ahead of that orca. And orcas ain't that fast, people. Especially not when they're, you know, wrecking boardwalks. No. Sound barrier is much slower than the speed of light. We can make jets that go much faster. And rockets that can go much faster than the speed of sound. Hence sonic booms. Oh, I will take some cash. Thank you kindly. What I would really like is a gun. Can we get me a gun, please? Yeah, I wasn't fond of that orca either. Why is he trying to kill Sonic? What'd Sonic ever do to him? Sonic murdered a bunch of baby orcas? Oh, okay. Well, I didn't know that part. Obviously, now I'm not on Sonic's side anymore. See, I guess he and Big the Cat went fishing one time, and then they caught a bunch of baby orcas. It's an extended reference to Sonic, the Sonic Adventure game. It was called Sonic Adventure.
I actually remember. Please be careful and
make your way across. Why did her Why does her voice echo if it's entirely happening inside my head? That's a puzzle the game doesn't have an answer for. Tell me more. Okay. Give me all this cash. We better find a vending machine soon. Repair kit, yes! I haven't played Apex or Valorant, unless you're talking about Apex Construct, which I've played a lot of. You're not, though. Nobody plays Apex Construct or talks about it, even though it's amazing. It's a VR archery game where you're caught in a digital space fighting spider robots. It's unbelievably badass. I'm always a huge fan. Oh, hi. Yeah, I tend not to play Street Side. I tend not to play online multiplayer shooters that are free to play, or at all. Just tend not to play multiplayer shooters. Every now and then, you know, get a game of Battlegrounds in, but that's pretty much it. The Power Stations, I just played Battlegrounds VR. That's pretty badass, actually. Each district and allow the power to be toggled between three states that consume different amounts of energy. On-off emergency. Okay, power will default to off if the level reaches zero. Good to know. The world require the power to be on or emergency to be used, such as store kiosks. Oh, nice. Will this give me some lights in here, please? Because that's been an issue. I would love more cash. Thank you. And this is technically a newer game than Apex, but an older one than Valorant. Hey, I grabbed a, I don't know, satellite dish? It was weird, whatever it was. Yeah, that's what the crack of a whip is. The sound barrier being broken. Because that's how fast it spins around. I would love to request energy. Oh, I could have just requested max. Great. And how do I work this part? Okay. That was a noisy click, lady.
Yep.
I don't judge. Power contained within the elders, within Eden's total reserves. Oh, good. It's full. Nice. But if I start putting energy to all of the various zones, it'll start running out of energy. Or maybe later I'll, like, I don't know, blow up a generator. Oh, yeah, it's clearly much brighter in here. Well, not much. Marginally brighter in here. No, we already searched there. Still no way to move this door. Sprint away, my darling. Oh, look! My stamina is no longer goes up to 100%, which means I'm probably thirsty. How do I use items? Item options, X. And that restored my stamina? No, it didn't. Huh. Well, that was a waste.
When they speak, the pace of each syllable takes many cycles of time. I often use the excess time reworking algorithms or communicating with hidden subsystems.
Creepy. Fun fact, there are 156 messages of those messages to listen to, which seems like a lot to me. Like, maybe too many. Just putting that out there. We'd love to call an elevator. Oh, I love you sci-fi elevators. Although this is more of a funicular, because it's going down at an angle. That's not the only way to make something a funicular versus an elevator. But it is a good sign. If it's going at a 45-degree angle from tracks, you might be on a funicular.
Originally, Jacob would converse with me every day, even nice. Insisting on being called my creator. I only understood the concept years later.
That's creepy. Why would you make someone call you their creator, even if you did create them? It's kind of a dick move. Not a fan of this Jacob guy, it turns out. Hello. Okay. Wait, that's back the way I came. Map, s'il vous plaît. That's data logs. There we go. There's the recycler, which again, I don't know how to use. Yeah, it is, Mike. And a father who insists on only ever being called father is very creepy. And someone you wouldn't want to be near, generally. Yes, father. Thank you, father. That kind of nonsense? Huh? I'm saying making your robot AI call you creator is creepy. Oh, you can repair things. Nice. Oh, I have a repair kit, right? Oh, no, I can salvage it. Thought I had a cyanotube repair. Oh, no, that's one of the things I destroyed. My bad.
There is another. The deep frame. Its cold texture doesn't permit even my slightest curiosity.
Cold texture? You know textures can't be cold, right? That's not what the word texture means. Very weird game. Although maybe she's being poetic. That could be the case. And if so, bad work designing your robot to be poetic. Spoiler alert, the last thing the world needs right now... World's got a lot of problems, okay? We're all getting killed by zombies. The last thing the world needs at the moment is robots doing poetry. Comprende? Okay, so that's a shutter locked for later. Gotta say, I'm a big fan of this game's environment. I do really like the look of this wrecked place. Maybe the shadows are doing a lot of the work for the game, but it is genuinely eerie. I thought that was another dude for me to punch out, but it was just a... Uh-oh. There he is.
He told white supremacists to stand by.
What?
Go.
He told white supremacists to stand by?
Please denounce white supremacists. Okay, stand back and stand by. But Antifa man, wow.
What?
He told them to stand by.
So he wants them ready to move when he tries to have a coup.
Yep.
Did he just punch me through plastic sheeting? I feel like that would kill most of the momentum of your attacks, right? Enjoying the animation on the punchy guys. It's kind of nice. No! They got me, everybody. Ah, we did okay. Alright, so this has been Pamela, a cute game. Now we don't have enough to respawn. Oh well. About exploring a completely wrecked future station. Obviously I'm going to say, well, it's cribbing from Bioshock and System Shock 2 and 100 other games, but it's got some nice style, like the look of the zombies. Not such a fan of the first-person combat, but definitely enjoying the environment and the story. For now, I've been the Hidden Object Guru. Thanks for coming on this journey with me. If you had a good time and you'd like to see more, there's buttons for that coming up. Questions, suggestions, related whatnots, go in the comments section below the video. I'll see you back here for more new and upcoming games, but until then... I'm going to say au revoir. Tell them the Proud Boys to stand by. You know they're actual Nazis, right? The Proud Boys. They're literally Trump's brown shirts.
Yep.
They even wear uniforms.
Yep.
Yeah, that's bad. That's real bad. Oof.
I'm never getting my red baseball cap back.
No, you're not. Nope, 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 nope. You're just going to have to dye it maroon. Honestly, next game, Mario might not be wearing a red baseball cap.
That's valid. To those who are listening, I'm angry because I have a Mario baseball cap, but last summer?
Yeah.
I was wearing it, and I noticed I would get weird looks.
Yeah.
And if I happened to get close to that person giving me a weird look... Like, there was a literal, like...
Oh, okay.
Oh, Mario!
It's fine, it's Mario.
Should I stop wearing a red baseball cap?
And the answer, sadly, is yes.
Is yes.
You're going to have to give it up. All right, I think we all know what it's time for. Another level of Bright Paw. The game where you play as Blofeld's cat.
Best game ever.
It's up there. All right, so I need you to help me find these collectibles. Question away, Horror King. It's true. Yeah. No more red hats, just like there's no more Hitler mustache. It's true.
Yep.
Oh, Michael Jordan trying to bring back the Hitler mustache, and then it turns out even he couldn't do it, so he gave it up.
Even Michael Jordan couldn't do that.
Ooh, horror game to turn into a horror movie to turn into a video game. That's tough. Oh, excuse me.
Horror movie to turn into a video game?
Yeah, it would be a good video game adaptation. I'll think about that.
It's strange that we've never had a Scream one, have we?
No.
Because I feel
The Scream Killer did show up in Dead by Daylight.
Like,
all right, hold on.
How
is this place still so tidy?
Yeah, Slasher Mystery game.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I would be down for that. We're talking about what you could do as a video game horror movie. And yeah, the Scream franchise would work as a video game. You're totally right. That's her answer is now my answer, too. I agree with her. Well-rooted bot.
Aww. You could have, like, a sequel where one of the options for a killer would be Silent Bob.
Aww.
Yeah, that's right. I'm referencing the time Silent Bob was in a Scream movie.
Yep.
I still don't know how I felt about that.
It's a weird movie, Scream 3.
Yeah. I mean, I didn't pay for it.
Certainly no Scream 2. But it's got some good stuff in it. Really, Lance Henriksen. Alright, so I can't see the other collectible. Help me out here. This is not you helping me out here. This is you being eerily silent while you scroll through your phone.
What's happening?
We're looking for the other collectible, the other shiny object.
Shiny.
You know how the objects blink?
It's not that screen, right?
What screen? Oh, no, this guy? That was the first one.
That screen.
Oh, nice. Good work. Image of a father, a mother, and a son standing beneath a tall tree.
A giant flickering thing.
I was looking at the tree. It was at the screen in front of it.
Yeah.
All right. I have psychic powers, you know. How do I use them? I can only put them there? What the hell is... I can teleport now? Oh my god, this kitten's amazing.
I feel like... Oh, what was it? Lance Henriksen. A Pumpkinhead?
Yeah, Pumpkinhead's pretty good.
Could be like a really creepy video game.
Is Pumpkinhead in Dead by Daylight yet? Because if not, it's a weird oversight.
Place. I don't suppose you've got any other tricks up your sleeve.
I do.
How did you even begin to try that?
Aww.
You know, the most disquieting thing about this entire situation is that despite all of my research and decades of questionable scientific investigation, I've never seen anything quite like your powers.
Really good point, Blofeld. God, this is such a good game. Hopscotch! The level's called Hopscotch.
Ah, this is more like it. They must have been trying to keep up appearances by sweeping all the mess back here. Seems like we're pretty hemmed in here, though, Theo.
God, Theo's the best. Toys for Joshua. Aww, never given. That's weird. Why didn't you give Joshua the toys? You okay?
Who is going to give Chris Wallace a hug and a stiff drink after this?
Oh, hopefully everyone.
That was a Dulce Sloan tweet.
Nice.
God, I love her.
Revolutionary Graffiti. First signs of a burgeoning uprising, the best metrics. Together machines. Oh, that's weird. You know you're good at robotics when the machines plan an uprising. Okay, that's very funny. Okay, so...
20 minutes after he told the Proud Boys to stand by...
Yeah?
He told his people to go to the polls and watch them.
Yeah, they're trying to intimidate people into not voting. That's the jive.
Well, scratch that. Folding space-time certainly makes navigating this junk easier. I forgot about these. They were toys for Joshua. I was going to give them to him when I finally introduced him and Lauren to my work. Just goes to show how old all this is.
Aww.
He's a man in his own right now.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, Ranger. I hope your family gets through this. Dead relative.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Alright, so go here.
God, the robots around here have been working away, keeping this place clean almost as long as he's been alive.
Dude, that's pretty upsetting.
Despite a decade or two without proper maintenance, the reactor seems to be doing well. I was concerned it might be choked with junk, but it seems it won't explode anytime soon. Oh, don't worry about all the lightning. It's supposed to look like that. Just don't get too close, and you'll be fine.
Pinwheel of electricity, 100% safe. Jesus. Ah, this game has got the sci-fi supervillain comedy down. Just right.
Aww.
I promise, it's safe. Enough.
Alright. I can see that working. Okay.
Really, Theo? It's probably
Psycho.
Fine.
What the heck? Alright, are you seeing anything glinting? This
it's
is your time to shine, woman.
Come on.
What? Glinty things?
I love that you're puzzled every... Okay, well, I found it. But I love that you're puzzled by it every time I ask you to help. Like, I haven't been asking you to help with every level of this game. The entire time. Yes, yes, keep doing the lizard look. I find it very authentic and believable. All right. Liquid media. Oh, my God. Alright, so we gotta get up to that wall so we can teleport through. Okay. Is that right?
Ah! Another bloody robot! Run for it, Theo!
No, none of this was right. Oh, I see what I was supposed to do. My bad. True, there are a lot of horror movie video games. I turned the wrong way. I'd say The Thing, obviously, but they already made a The Thing video game, and it was not good. Not good at all. Theo, you've got this. You're the man, Theo. Or... conversely.
It appears your teleport trick stopped it dead in its tracks. Well,
oh, weird.
As nice as that is, there's no guarantee it will last.
That's
Let's
what
not
the,
stick around to test the theory.
That's what that field that gets left when you teleport does. It EMPs robots. You have a good night, Horror King.
How on earth have they kept this place
Whoa.
So clean when they keep doing things like this? If your powers prevented the last robot from chasing us, I wonder what it would do to one of these.
Aww. Damn. No, that's not gonna work. That was the wrong button, everybody.
Oh, thank God. I was sure it was just going to explode. But it should be safe to keep doing this. Probably.
How I like your attitude, buddy boy.
Looking before you leap. Why would they bother to expose the wiring like this? It's obvious they aren't doing anything with it. You would think I'd engineered the laser units purely to destroy my own property. That was a little bit too close for comfort. Guess it's good to know the limitations of your powers, if only to know when we need to run.
Aww. I can see that, Matt. BioShock movies? Definitely something that they've tried to adapt, and I guess it just hasn't happened.
It's a lot closer to us than I'd like. But this time, we can do something about it.
You're darn right we can. What? What can we do about it? Decontamination blueprint. Oh. Aww. Yay! Alright, so what are my moves, buddy boy? What happened?
Merriam-Webster. Stand back to take a few steps backwards. Stand by to be or to get ready to act.
Yep.
The freaking dictionary just tweeted out definitions of his word.
Oh, whoops, that was the wrong one. Yeah. No, he didn't say step back, he said stand by.
And he said all... step back, stand by.
Yeah.
He said both.
Oh, he said both?
Yeah, he said step back, and then he said stand by.
God, the man's a buffoon. Huh. I'm very confused about what I'm supposed to do here, because I have to end up turning right. But how do I do that when my turning right movement takes me there? See? Oh, I can teleport sideways. I'm not smart. I've already forgotten the rules of how this game works. And that'll freeze him.
Ha ha! Take that! This new ability of yours is proving very useful, don't you think? Now, we just need to traverse that gap.
Consider yourself teleported.
I don't want you getting a big head, but that was good thinking.
Aww.
God, this kitten's the best. I call him Fluffers. That's not his name. Those lasers are about to start shooting. I have to assume. Oh, yay! I can use my psychic powers to move it! And that one. Cool. Oh, cared for photograph of Lauren holding her newborn child filled with love. Damn it. Look! Aww. It's the guys from the fake Banjo and Kazooie sequel. What were they called? You have a good night, Ranger, and stay strong.
Wait.
Alright. Yeah, no, see you back here. Whenever you want to drop by, we're here every night. Hanging out and talking about a little thing called the movie Scream. Seriously, Scream's a great movie.
No.
Yeah, I figured. Alright, so...
Lovely! Just lovely! I doubt we can stun them all. We may have to come up with a different strategy.
Teleport. Psychic block. Turn right.
Well done, Theo. That should give us a little breathing room.
Not really. Teleport. And we do it. Hey, Cameron. Ukulele, thank you. Which is weird, because Banjo-Kazooie were two different musical instruments, but this time it's just one.
This was going to be a place to relax and sit back with a book. Me and Lauren were going to be able to work together, and
yeah.
Joshua would have had an amazing place to grow
Aww.
Up. Looks more like a construction site now.
But you're right. Step back and stand by means don't make a fuss now or you'll get arrested. Wait to make a fuss until it's time to commit crimes for, you know, your dear leader. He's making some weird moves. robot in there. Oh, that's so cute. God, this game's adorbs. Humble receptacle of memories of some exciting life-changing events, or perhaps just a watering can. Banjo-Kazooie was amazing. I agree with you 100%. I love that game.
Yeah.
I have not played Yooka-Laylee, even though I own it, and probably its sequel. I know it already had a sequel. The hell is that? Oh, that counts as a move. I forgot that counts as a move. Does anybody see the last glinting item? It's not these shock pads on the floor.
The tank?
Tank?
On the wall, yeah.
Oh. No. Alright, well, we'll keep an eye out. Is he stuck? I think he's stuck. Weird. Oof. Well, this is a rough situation. No, that's not gonna help. See, if I teleport to the other side, how am I gonna turn right?
See a way past this laser, Theo.
See? I'm not facing the right way. But my only move takes me right into the laser, and I can't block it. Will he block the lasers there on one move? Oh. Y'all can just, yeah. I'm as ashamed as anyone.
That angry robot is adorbs.
Isn't the angry robot dangerously super adorbs? He's so mad! Oh. I made him go the other way by moving the thing so he couldn't go that way. It was a brilliant technique. That's fine. That's fine. Okay, it's not fine. So you're just gonna sit there? Hmm. So is that just his destination point, and there's nowhere else he's ever going to move? Because that could be a problem for me. Yeah, look, he's not going to turn around and go the other way.
Can you put that wall on top of your kitty cat?
Yeah, that was a glitch. Oh, no, I can hide inside the wall. Just like that robot can hide inside that wall. The sequel was good? Okay. The ukulele. No, it's not the laser thing to click on. Hmm. Okay. Alright, so now... It seems like this is my only move here. Then how do I deal with this guy? Again, now he just has no other moves. Will he develop a new move by... No, he just gives up. What if I teleport into him? I can't play the teleport card because there's nowhere for me to teleport? Alright, let me try something. Can I teleport into this thing? No, I can't. Doing something wrong here. I don't see what it is. I guess I was supposed to trap him back there? And now I move this here. Oh, now he's coming for me again. Hmm.
How insist Trump is a religious man, I'll grant you, he pays taxes like a church.
Boom!
Students are there.
I would imagine. So if I move this here, he'll walk there. Then I have to move it back so I can go. Now I lock him in there. Okay. I moved it too many times and it kept me from locking him in there the way I was supposed to. Alright, there we go. The MP field is a nice choice. Working out? Is this a gym? It's a gym, everybody.
It may shock you, but I've always seen the benefits of physical fitness as well as mental prowess. I thought it would be good for the whole family to stay in shape.
Okay. Punching bag hanging here unused for years. Oh, that's nice. More pictures of the family. Did I just see something move here? Something glint? No, I already clicked on that. Why is it still glinting? Well, that's obviously a glitch, because this isn't still glinting. Thing on the walls? No, it doesn't look like it. You know, we can always come back for this jive later. I'm not gonna worry about it. Alright, so... So then I teleport here.
Watch your step, Theo. Unexplained psychic powers won't prevent you tripping and bumping your head.
Oh, I see. Oh, no, this one.
I think it was when I was building this that I realized it would never work out. Lauren would have questioned where the funds came from, and she would have never accepted the truth. She had a very firm outlook on morality, you see.
Oh. So he had to build his giant house inside the lab in secret. Ah! You have a good night, Cameron. Hope to see you back soon.
I would usually advise we find another route. But you seem to have developed a knack for problem solving by defying the laws of physics. So, what have you got up your sleeve this time?
Obliterated doorway. Yeah, I know. Yes?
Daily Show posted a meme. Shut the fuck up, Donnie. Big Lebowski.
I guess he's doing a live show.
Yep.
His laboratories, you say? Alright, so I've got that. No, not today. Can only jump one, though. And I need to move two space, more than two spaces. So how do we do that? This is a skill set we have yet to Oh, I can teleport through the wall. Duh. Which way? Probably forward, right? Yeah. So... Psychic.
Ha! Now that's thinking outside the box, Theo. My god. It's a total disaster area. What happened in here? Oh, no, no, no!
Not my intention. Don't worry, I clicked on the wrong button. It's fine.
Ha! Now that's thinking outside the box, Theo. My god. It's a total disaster area. What happened in here?
Oh crap, we're moving to the same place.
You're getting awfully good at juking those. Even you'll have issues sleeping through all this rubble, Theo. Let's find another path before that chaser wakes up.
Oh, I have to teleport through the wall again. Okay. I was very confused about what I was supposed to be doing.
Time to go, Theo, quickly. Oh no, we're trapped. I hope you remember how to repeat your latest trick.
Aww. Theo, you're the man. Or, conversely, the cat. What the hell happened there? Oh, I clicked on the pause button accidentally. That's a new one. Take that, sucker. Thanks, Mike! Always great to see you. As everyone else has fled.
It's distressing to see the garden like this. Aww. I was hoping it might have escaped the decline that befell the labs.
Oh, I think it still looks nice. Sock monkey! It's not the first sock monkey we found. I wonder how that game that's just Dead Island, but with VR is doing. I should check that. Crashed helicopter, the pilot was at no fault here, though perhaps they should have questioned their order to land a helicopter inside a cave. Aww. Okay.
I stumbled upon this cave while I was building, and I thought it would make a lovely space for the family. Plenty of room for Joshua to play, and some nice plants for Lauren and I. I always planned to build a nice gazebo just over there. A serene place to just relax and take... Is that a bloody crashed helicopter? What? That's a Fennec chopper! MI5 standard!
Yeah.
Her answer was, it's a dog whistle through a bullhorn.
Nice. Are you ready? Look. Okay. It's James Bond's parachute from Spy Who Loved Me. You should be more delighted, weirdo.
I am. It took me a second to recognize it.
It's okay, Mike. It comes down to what you're, how into stabbing zombies in the face you are. If you're really into stabbing zombies in the face, it's going to be your game. But I would say 80% of the game's content is grabbing zombies by the neck with one hand and stabbing them with the other hand. That has a knife in it.
Those bastards have been after me for years! Is this how the killer got past all my security? Ha! Good thing they went down trying to land in here. There might be something useful in the wreckage. Theo, we've got to go and take a look.
God. This game's so amazing.
Come on, Theo! Just a little closer!
Oh. Oh no! Theo! Oh, poor Theo. Yeah, well, like at the beginning, we found them all dead. Then we're like, did their son come back and kill them?
Theo, come on, get
and
up,
then,
Theo.
Oh,
thank God. For a second there, I
we found out he was Blofeld. Dead cat. Oh, my God. Then we find out it's a game about Blofeld and Blofeld's cat. And I'm like, oh, so James Bond came and killed everybody, which is pretty cool. Yes, but it's less cartoony here. Saints and Sinners had that cel-shaded cartoony art style, and this is a much more realistic zombie face-stabbing game. Don't know why I'm just going to suggest that's a good thing. All right, we're going to wrap up Brightpaw here for today. I've been the Hidden Object Guru. Thanks for coming on this journey with me. If you had a good time and you'd like to see more, there's buttons for that coming up. Questions, suggestions, related whatnots, go in the comments section below the video. We'll see you back here for more Brightpaw in the next item on the playlist, because this is an incredible game that we're playing all of. But until then, I'm going to say that's right. Au revoir. Basically, I don't know if you know a ton about the game, but the idea is it's a... it's plot-based, like... what do you call it? Arizona Sunshine? But there are also repeatable, slightly randomized missions that you go on to find supplies in order to build up Alexandria's population. It's kind of nice. I wouldn't say it's great. The big problem with it is that...
What?
New kittens.
Yay, new kittens!
Shaded mackerel. Look. And?
Ooh.
Yep. It's a psychic kitten.
Psychic kitten.
Once you've used all of Theo's powers, you unlock psychic kitten.
Psychic kitten.
I know, isn't that amazing? Oh, God, this game's great. It's a cool game. I am very... the real problem with it, though, is that like, you have to shoot zombies three to four times in the head to kill them. And I'm like, I've got a gun. I shot a zombie. The zombie should die. I'm like, am I this bad a shot? I'm like, no, their heads are ricocheting around. They're just not dying. So at one point, I literally grabbed a zombie by the neck, put the gun up to its eye, and pulled the trigger. And, like, nothing happened. Got a little blood. And he kept going, I'm a zombie. So I had to shoot him twice more, again, at point-blank range, while holding the zombie's neck in my hand. It was very frustrating. All right, so that's it for the stream tonight. Thanks, everybody, who dropped by. I hope you had a good time. I know I did. We're going to be back here tomorrow for more Beyond Blue. Maybe somebody will send me a new game. Who knows? And, of course, we're closing in on the end of Brightpaw, so that should be a lot of fun. We'll see you back here for that. But until then, I'm going to say... It's funny that you say, is it better than Survival Instinct? When the game first started, it started with you playing a guy with a gruff voice who was looking for Daryl in, like, a park, and you had to go through this, like, ravine full of zombies. And I'm like, is this a VR remake of Survival Instinct? Because this is exactly how Survival Instinct started. But you were not playing as Daryl's dad. You were playing as Rick, and it just has a terrible voice actor. All right, so I'll see you back here tomorrow. But until then, lates.